Thank you and welcome to the PBNZ Sports
Chaos Show.
Nice! Right. Great introduction. Go Bees! All right. This week, hey, by the way, little shout out, Ipswich Eel, right? Little Route 101 from the Ipswich Eel Brewers. Ipswich Eel Brewers, excuse me, up in Ipswich, Massachusetts. Nice. It's a fine beer. What do they got? They got tap room hours 7 days a week, right?
Yeah, the brewery's open every day till 11 o'clock, Sundays till 9. Go out and check it out.
Oh, yeah, especially now the warm weather's coming. All right, we're moving on, folks. Here we go. Two-minute update coming up in a minute here, and we're going to talk in circles. We're going to talk a little auto racing. I know we've said before we wouldn't do it, but we will. Here we go. We got Indy 500 and the Monte Carlo this weekend. And playoffs.
Playoffs?
Did you say playoffs? Yes, NHL, NBA playoffs coming up. We're going to talk about the finals that we expect in the NBA. We already know the NHL. We'll talk about that momentarily. And we got a good one this week for you. Sports rivalries. Yeah.
That'll be fun.
Oh, yeah. We got some DYKs as we usually do. Speaking of DYKs, did you hear this one? The Angels were rained out Wednesday night, the first time since 2015. Wow. Can you believe that?
Well, you know, it never rains in California.
Correct, because it's only the 17th time in the history of the franchise it's ever rained out. Hey, I just changed my retirement plans after I heard that. I'm moving to Anaheim. Next time you see me, I'll be in Anaheim in my retirement home. All right. Hey, MLB Red Sox, PB. I'm going to ask you a question. I bet you don't know this answer. Who is leading the major leagues with the best record in baseball?
Well, given the fact that the Red Sox are going into a series this weekend with the Astros, I'll go Houston.
And you would be incorrect. Oh. It's none other than the Minnesota Twins. Who figured that? They hit 8 home runs last night. Apparently, they're up to like 100 home runs already after 51 games with the best record in major leagues. And speaking of the other teams in the American League in first place, none of those Houston Astros. We have a big series this weekend, right?
Yeah, big one.
By the way, did you know this is the last time we play them for the rest of the regular season?
Really? Already?
That's it, yeah, wow. Yeah. And, oh, speaking of rivalries, apparently the Astros consider us a rival. Did you know that? After 3 years in the American League, we're rivals.
Yeah, well, that's just a bit show there.
Moving on. Hey, by the way, the Yankees, I'm a little bit concerned. They have a 6-game lead on us. Are you worried?
Yeah, I'd be very worried. They haven't played. I mean, half the team's hurt.
They got a AAA roster.
And they're still winning, and I predict them to win the division. I think they're going to run away with it.
Run away with it, huh?
Yeah.
Oh. Speaking of running away, right now, who is the runaway leader for the American League Rookie of the Year in your mind?
Well, I mean, this kid Chavis is definitely making a good run at it, right?
He hit another one the other night. What's he up to, 10, right? The game winner, right? Yeah. Extra innings, the 13th?
Yeah. Timely home runs.
Oh, my God. I believe he's the runaway winner. Hey, little football news for you. Julian, our boy Julian, we love Jules, right?
Love him.
He signed a 2-year extension. What did he get, $18 million, you said?
Yeah, I think it was 18.
And by the way, what happened to our offensive tackle backup we signed?
I know.
Valdea?
Then
he signed with the Pats?
And then he retires, right?
He retires! He didn't even wait around for a ring! What the heck? At least wait around for a ring, dude! By the way, I love this story. Big Ben Roethlisberger. He came out and said, you know what? Maybe I was too hard on Anthony Brown. A, B, and me. I could have been nice. Blah, 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 blah.
Right.
What do you got to say about that?
A, B should stand for A, baby.
Oh! A, you know what? I'm going to buy a Raiders shirt with that on it. A, baby. I love it! Oh, yes! All right. Hey. For the ladies, we got a little women's sports going on, right? We got a little WNBA action. The regular season starts this week. And we got women's softball, right, Miss Sky? Who do you like? Oklahoma. All right.
Oklahoma.
There you go. Sooners. Their 41-game winning streak was broken, but they won the next day, and they're in the Super Regionals. Good for them. By the way, they had back-to-back no-hitters. That was unbelievable. Hey, little fun fact here. James Madison, the Dukies from James Madison down in Virginia, right? Richmond, Virginia. They had to win 2 games in a row to go to the Super Regional against Michigan. Michigan won all of the softball championship 3 years, I think it's 4 years ago now. And they had to beat them
Michigan lost. James Madison won, so good for the Dukies. By the way, I got a little one for you. Speaking of college sports, did you hear this one about LSU? Baseball?
No, I didn't.
LSU, so they're in the conference playoffs. They went to extra innings on Tuesday night. It ended sometime after midnight. I don't know, 1, 1:32. But Wednesday night, they played again in extra innings after midnight. You know what time the game ended?
2.
Oh, at 2 hours. 4:02, the game got over.
Wow.
And then they had to play a winner-take-all the next... Well, that day! What am I talking about next? That day at 4 o'clock. Unbelievable.
So what about this Stevie Wise? She's a great story, right?
Speaking of women's softball, yes. UCLA, right?
UCLA, talk about having your heart in the game. I mean, she needs heart surgery.
Literally.
And she's putting it off. She's putting it off to finish through the playoffs. And just that just takes a lot of guts, a lot of determination. Give her all the credit in the world. So just wanted to do a shout-out to
Stevie. Her life's on the line, theoretically,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, I wanted to give a shout-out to her.
Thank you. That's a good call out. All right. Hey, by the way, we like to talk about all things sports. We talked about the boxing match last week with Dante Wilder. And what the heck happened?
He clocked him, right? Knocked him out.
He said the only sport you can kill a man and not get arrested. And he literally almost killed that dude, right? Unbelievable. Fantastic. Hey, by the way, we know we're not big in horse racing, but we love the Triple Crown races, and they will not go away. The story does not go away, right? So first of all,
it's
we had the
opera.
Double winners in the Kentucky Derby, right?
Yeah.
Soap opera?
Yeah.
And then this past week in the Preakness.
Oh, my God.
The horse that won was the horse that was bumped into in the Kentucky Derby,
yeah.
Right? It was a 6-1 odds. Not the favorite, he ended up winning. But what was the story of that race?
Oh, it was Boat Express.
Your horse.
My long shot horse.
Your long shot, Boat Express.
Comes out of the gate, throws his jockey for
the horse.
Off the horse. Runs the race.
The whole race.
You know, and he does pretty well, hangs in there. He's in the middle
of
the pack.
He was in the pack for most of the race.
Oh, it was great. But
it was the hottest news on Twitter. Oh, man.
So needless to say, no Triple Crown winner this year.
No.
We'll have our Belmont preview in a week or so.
All right. And then wrapping it up, PGA Championship. Hey, you predicted this thing. Brooks
Koepka.
There you go.
Yep.
You said 10-1 odds, bet him, fans. That was like 2 weeks before the tournament you told us to bet him, right?
And he ran away with it, but then on the Sunday, in the final round, almost
7 bogeys?
Wow. That was, yeah. If he blew that lead, that would have been an epic failure.
Greg Norman-esque.
Yeah, but he pulled it up. I'm happy for him.
Hey, by the way, that's his fourth major in the last 3 years.
I know. He's a hot
qualifier.
Right? He's hot.
All right. Time to take this conversation in your favorite place, PB. We're going to talk in circles, right? A little auto racing. We got Indy 500 this weekend, right? What do you think? What do you got?
So for the Indy 500, there's a couple of obvious favorites in this one. Alexander Ross and Will Power, both 7.5-1. Alexander Ross, he was a rookie in 16, and he won the Indy 500 that year. And then the following 2 years, he finished 7th, and then he finished 4th. But what's interesting about his 4th-place finish last year is he was the favorite to win that race, even though he was starting in the very back row.
He was.
So imagine
last place.
Back
right.
row, still the favorite, and still ended up finishing 4th. So he's a hot one. I can see
right.
him pulling this off. The defending champion is Will Power. He's had 4 top 5 finishes in the last 5 races. So he's just there every single time. So you can't discount him. And then you have Simon Pagenaud, I think is how you pronounce his name.
Yeah, yeah.
And he just came off the IndyCar Grand Prix, and he won that. So
okay.
he's pretty hot as well.
Okay.
But I'm going to go, one of those three I think will be in there at the end. But my long shot pick, going with the pedigree, going with Marco Andretti.
Oh, another Andretti?
Got to go Marco. He's 14-1 right now.
How many are there? It's unbelievable.
Yeah, and then you got the Grand Prix, too, this week.
Oh, yes. Our favorite kind of auto racing, because it's street racing, right? Formula One on the streets of Monte Carlo. By the way, that starts at 9 a.m., and I think I'll be drinking a little Ipswich 101 at 9 a.m. on Sunday, watching that.
Spoken like a true car racing fan.
Oh, yes! I'm in the family now. Thank you, auto racing fans. All right, moving on. We're going to talk NHL. Whoa! Here we go. Bruins are playing. playing the Blues. What do you think?
I'm excited as hell. I mean, it's been a long, too long of a wait, though, right? I mean, we've been sitting around for a while. The Bruins,
it'll be 9 days.
The Bruins, I think, will be on 10 or 11 days rest when they play. And the Blues are going to have quite a bit of rest as well.
Right.
It's going to be a great series. I think they're going to battle it out. I can see it being low scoring. St. Louis is tough. They're like a combination to me of Toronto and Columbus with the physicality of Columbus,
the
with the speed of Toronto.
Yeah.
They're going to give them some fits, I think. Bruins are hot. They're playing well. You know, Toronto's, I mean, I'm sorry, St. Louis's strength really is going to be in their, you know, their transition game, coming through the neutral zone. They're going to be staying out of the penalty box. There'll be a lot of 5-on-5 time. Bruins' strength is the special teams. They're great shorthanded. They're great on the power play. Problem is, as I said, St. Louis, they stay out of the box.
Stay out of the box.
So 5-on-5 hockey, it's going to come down to the defense. I think the Bruins have a rock solid defense. And then if Tuukka plays like he's been playing, he's going to be lights out.
Is he the favorite for the Calder Trophy, the most valuable player in the playoffs?
He very well could be. I really like, ultimately, in the end here, the Bruins pull off the series. St. Louis, great story. January 1st, best team, worst team in the NHL, 300-1 odds to win the Cup. And here they are in the Cup. So, second half of the season, probably one of the best teams in the NHL. But I think their Cinderella story is coming to a close. I think the big bad Bruins are going to just step in their way.
So that's your prediction.
Bruins. I'm going to go Bruins in six. They'll take it in St. Louis.
In St. Louis.
And they won't get to play that freaking song Glory that they've been playing every time they win.
Hey, by the way, I know you have something about Glory at one moment, but let me ask you this question. A little DYK fans, speaking of St. Louis and the city of Boston, did you know how many times Boston and St. Louis is paired up in the four major sports for a championship?
Oh, man. So you got the Red Sox beat the Cardinals
twice
in 04.
Yeah.
And I know they beat them in 67, I believe. So I think they've won a couple there. The Patriots beat the Rams, Brady's first Super Bowl, when the Rams were in St. Louis. And the Bruins beat the Bobby Orr goal, right, to sweep the series in 72.
The Flying Orr goal, yes.
And I think they beat him one other time as well. So I'm going to say five times.
You were close, but you're wrong. The Boston, city of Boston has
been. Oh, the Red Sox lost in 67.
Correct.
Finals. So,
yes.
Okay. So five times, maybe we're 4-1.
So we played St. Louis 10 times in major championships.
Wow. Okay.
The Bees are 2-0. You had that right.
All right.
The Sox are 2-2. So they won in 13. The Celtics played the old St. Louis Hawks way back before you and I were born.
Oh, yeah.
And they were 3-1. Okay. The Pats, as you called it, were 1-0 as well. So all together, we are 7-3 against the city of St. Louis,
nice.
The city of beer, Anheuser-Busch. Sorry, we love you, beer, but we're going to win. All right, moving on. NBA.
Well, we got a little Glory, my Gloria thing.
Oh, you got the Gloria thing. That's right.
Yeah, yeah.
So, talk about this, because
so
another reason why I can't pick this team from
St. Louis. Right. Yeah, so, you know, what do they got going for them? Well, they adopted this song, and I was looking at it today, and I said, you know,
the Laura Branigan song.
The Laura Branigan song, right? Calling Gloria. So I go ahead, and I look up the first four lines of the lyrics, right? And I just want to read these. I'm not going to sing them. I'm going to read them to you, and I want you to tell me if you would want this to be your theme song. Ready? Gloria, you're always on the run now. Running after somebody, you gotta get him somehow. I think you've got to slow down before you start to blow it. I think you're headed for a breakdown, so be careful not to show it. Like, why?
WTF.
Why?
What?
I know. Why in God's name would you want to have a theme song with those lyrics in it? I don't know. It is a catchy song, I'll give you that, but
Well, when the music's playing, obviously we can't hum the music. But anyways, whoa, all right, that's their song.
That's their song.
Do they sing it every game after they win?
I think they play, yeah, after they win, they play it all across the whole thing, whatever.
We're moving on to another miserable scene, NBA and the Lakers. By the way, this week the Lakers, as the world turns in LA, Magic came out and said all the horror stories behind the scenes, the general manager stinks, everybody's cutting his back, blah, 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 blah. Who wants to go play for the Lakers right now? Would you?
No.
No. LeBron, I'm sorry. No, 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 no. Oh, we can't say that on YouTube. But anyways, you're never going to win a championship again in L.A. All right, moving on. By the way, the Warriors are now in their fifth straight finals. And you predicted it. And you also said they're a dynasty in the making, which they may be if they win this one. By the way, it's the first time, get this, PB, since the 50s/60s Celtics, which went 10 series in a row in the finals with Russell, Cousy, and the likes of Havlicek and so-and-so.
Yep.
So the first time anybody's gone five or more since then.
It's impressive.
What do you think?
Are they going to pull it off? It's a dynasty. I think they're going to win.
You said it before. They're a dynasty, right?
Yep.
Even without KD. If KD doesn't play.
Doesn't matter. Look what they do. Look what
doesn't matter.
Look what they did against Portland without him. I mean, they're going to be fine. So, I predicted them to win. And they're going to face Toronto, which is who I picked as their opponent before the NBA playoffs even started. And I do think Toronto's going to end up winning that series.
So you got Toronto winning tomorrow night or in seven?
I would like to see them win tomorrow night, just to get it over with. If they do lose tomorrow, Game 7 is just going to be an epic game. It'll be a game for the ages.
It will be, yes.
And you'll have road teams winning Game 5, road team winning Game 6, and then you're going to be in Game 7, right?
Ooh, so that would be good.
But for Toronto to drop two straight right now to Milwaukee would be a disappointment. So okay. I'm going to go Toronto.
Toronto?
And then I think Golden State can take them in 5 or 6.
With or without KD?
It doesn't matter.
Either way.
It doesn't matter.
Either way.
And here's the thing. If Milwaukee somehow gets into that final series, I think Golden State sweeps the Bucks.
Oh! Hey, speaking of the Bucks, did you see this one last night? So, a little beer-chugging contest on the sidelines with some of the Green Bay Packers. The big offensive tackle drank 2 16-ounces in, like, I don't know, 8 seconds, God forbid. And then he challenged his quarterback, A-Rod, Aaron Rodgers, to drink his beer, which, by the way, was a third full. Aaron could not finish it, lame duck Aaron, right? and then his boy, the offensive tackle, didn't finish the third one right after that. Unbelievable. Yeah. That was a good competition.
He drank 3 beers in, like, what, 20 seconds?
Yeah.
Yeah. And that would take us, like, what, a minute and 20 seconds?
At least, right? Oh. Oh, my God. Hey, by the way, Julian, what do you think? He would have crushed Rodgers.
Oh, yeah. Julian can really, he can put him back. Gronk, too.
Gronk as well, yeah.
That's all right. You should have a beer drinking contest for, like, NFL skills competition.
That's it? Whoa! Hey, at NFL, hashtag NFL, we're coming at you. All right, moving on. Speaking of rivalry type stuff, right? Besides beer drinking contests, let's talk about real rivalries. Tell me, we got two things I want to talk about this afternoon.
All right.
Your current best rivalry in any sport and your all-time best rivalry in any sport.
All right, so this is fun. I'm excited to talk about this all week. All right, so here we go. So current, right now, right?
Yes.
Here we go. Number 5 for me, and these are going to be a little out of the box, folks. Number 5, LSU and Florida in football. Two powerhouses in the SEC. Reason why I'm going with this one is my personal experience being in New Orleans, being at a house party, watching the Tigers and the Gators go head to head. You got the Swamp against the Bayou. It was just a really, really fun time. So I'm going with LSU Florida, number 5. Number 4, here we go. U.S. women's soccer team versus the world.
What? And versus anybody in the world.
In the world. Versus just their presence in the cup. We got the World Cup starting on June 7th, right? In France, June 7th.
Bring it on. We got our World Cup preview coming up.
Absolutely. So, they've won the champ. They won it last World Cup. They went to the finals the cup before that. They've won 3 out of the 7 cups. I think that them against the world.
All
right. And the timing for it's perfect. So when you say right now, U.S. women soccer is definitely there. Number 3 for me is going to be NCAA Hoops going Duke, North Carolina.
Yes, I agree with that one. Yes.
And you look at the this season and the times they played each other in the regular season, then they played each other in the ACC Championship. It was just unbelievable basketball. Zion, out for one of the games in the regular season, comes back in the postseason. It was just fantastic basketball to watch. Number 2, I'm going New England Patriots and the Kansas City Chiefs. We're talking current.
I would have said Steelers, but you're saying Chiefs.
The Steelers suck. The Steelers suck.
Here but they've go. Had a good rivalry for 15, 16
but,
years.
But you're saying, yeah, that would be historically. I'm talking about, these are my current ones. You have them currently. Right now, the Patriots and the Chiefs are the two best teams playing the AFC.
Okay.
They played each other in the AFC Championship game last year.
Yeah, they played each other
in the regular season last year. I was at that game. 43-40, the Patriots won. They
one of the best games of the season, right?
Yeah, and they've been playing each other every season because they're finishing first. And a couple of times the Chiefs have smoked us, right?
Right?
That was the On to Cincinnati. Remember the On to Cincinnati game?
That's
that was coming off a Chiefs loss. And then when the Patriots lost the AFC Championship game to Denver, they played the Chiefs in the playoffs to get to that game. And I was at that game as well.
All right, good point.
So that, to me, is a really big rivalry. And I would expect to see those two perhaps meeting again in the next year or two in the AFC playoffs.
They got the guns, I agree.
Yeah. And then number one overall, and this might sound a little crazy, I'm going to back this up, though, is Golden State and Houston.
That's my honorable mention. All right. I can see me going with that one.
Number one overall, and here's why. I'm going to back it up.
Stats?
I'm going to back it up. In 2015, Golden State beat Houston in the Western Conference Finals.
Okay.
In 2016... Golden State beat Houston in the first round.
So two. Okay.
17, Houston unfortunately was eliminated by the Spurs in the second round, but would have, if they had won, played in the
Golden
conference
State.
Finals again, but they didn't get them that time. And then 18.
Three.
In the finals again.
Yeah.
Western Conference Finals. Golden State beat Houston. And then this year, Golden State beat Houston in the semis. So four of the last 5 years, Golden State and Houston have met in the playoffs, in the Western Conference Finals, or in other rounds. And Golden State's won every one of them. Houston's just trying to get over that hump. Look at that. That is a big, big rival. That's number one.
I like that. All right, man. I you know what? That's my honorable mention. I get you there. All right. Let me give you mine before we move on to the all-timers, right?
Mm-hmm.
So, I'm on your side with this one. Duke versus North Carolina in basketball. Although I'm not a fan of
either
team.
Are you going 5-1 or 1-5?
I'm
going to
go from 1-5.
Oh, so you're okay. You're working. Okay. All right.
Duke, North Carolina, number one. As much as I hate to say this, Michigan, Ohio State in football.
All right.
That's intense. Alabama and Auburn, another one I hate, but that game gets better and better every year.
The Iron Bowl.
And then I got this at 4. In my mind, it's 1 and number all time, and I'll talk about that. Sox. Yankees is always best bet.
But I can see where historically that would be higher than current. Because right now it's not as intense as it used to be.
Right. Oh, yeah. There's
I
no
that.
Fight.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. And I'm going to go out of the box as well. Roger Federer versus either the Joker or Nadal. You could take either one of the three of them, whatever it is.
Okay.
They seem to be playing for all of the Grand Slam tournaments. That's the best tennis going on in the last 7 years altogether.
All right.
So that's what I got. And my outside shot is Dodgers Giants, because that's always entertaining.
Yeah, okay, I can go that.
What do you got for all-timers?
So all-time, I'm going to go with my growing up, my childhood, and what had an impact on me in my life watching sports growing up. Because, you know, if you look at it historically, this wouldn't make sense. So for those viewers that aren't from the New England area, you're not going to like these ones, but this is for me.
You're missing something, because these are great!
Right, and some of these would probably be historical as well, like the Sox-Yankees. Okay, that's got to be number one.
You can't beat that, man. Come on. Gedman throws A-Rod on the ground. I mean, Veritek throws A-Rod on the ground, right?
Yeah. Pedro and Zimmer.
Oh, my God.
So that's number one. I got number two. I got the Bruins and Canadians.
Oh, you know what? That's my honorable mention. You know what? That's pretty good.
That's a good one, right? They played each other in the Cup in the 70s
Yes. Too many men on the ice.
Can't happen these days with the way the league's aligned, but... and then Celtics-Lakers. That's probably on some people's all-time list as well. The Red Sox-Yankees, Celtics-Lakers, I think people could put in the historical all-time. But I'm just, again, impact as a kid. So there's three right there. My fourth one, interesting here, BC versus Notre Dame in college football. And I'm going with this one because they, you know, it's the Catholic, right? It's the only two Division I Jesuit schools in NCAA football.
Okay.
Right? And their matchups are always great and were great back in the day. And then, number five, I'm not going with teams. I'm going with people on number five. I'm going to go Brady versus Manning.
Oh, okay. All right. Whoa. That's pretty good. I got an honorable mention like that. It was Bird versus Magic, but it's not my final. Okay.
All right. So what are your all-timers?
All-timers. I have to go Yankee Sox.
Okay.
It has to be Yankee Sox in my mind. Followed by, I got one of yours as well, another one of yours, Celtics-Lakers, which I did not know. They played in the NBA Finals 12 times. And by the way, they're the two all-time winningest programs, 17 and 16 championships. So yep. that's an obvious one.
Yep.
I got to give Duke and North Carolina. It never gets old, as much as I'm not a fan of either school.
So they made your current and your historic.
That's right.
Okay.
And I got one that could always be current and historic as well. It's on my bucket list. I got to go to this game one year. Army versus Navy in football.
I like that. I actually looked at that on my list because I do remember that as a kid too, growing up, because that was always played on the Friday after Thanksgiving, right?
Yeah, now it's played on the Saturday.
And
the
there was
first
nothing else
December.
Going on that day, yeah. usually, and you'd watch that game, and it was the Army-Navy game, and it had all the hype, and it was played at the old vet, right?
Right.
Yeah. So, yeah, that's good. That's a great one. I like that.
And I still, as much as I don't like the Big Ten, I think Michigan and Ohio State is a big one. But I will give honorable mention to the NFC East against any one of their other opponents, because Cowboys, Eagles, Redskins, Giants, the only division in football that has a Super Bowl winner out of every team. Yeah. And it's always blood every game. It doesn't matter, right?
Yeah, and I feel like there's a different division winner every year, too.
They have a streak, you said earlier.
Yeah,
right?
I think they do have one of the longest streaks.
But God forbid, Philadelphia, they booed Santa Claus, they booed Troy Aikman with a broken neck or whatever he had sitting on the ground, threw snowballs at him. That's a bitter rivalry, for sure.
Yeah.
Oh, man. All right, hey. We talked about golf a little earlier today. What about Connor, Nicklaus versus Palmer?
Yeah, that's another one. You could put
right?
that in there. Yeah, you could put that in there.
All right.
Yeah.
And I'll give you one for note today. I know you said BC, but the best one of all time, I'm sorry that the rivalry is over, convicts versus Catholics. How could you forget about that one?
The U.
Miami, right?
Yeah.
Versus the Notre Dame Fighting Irish. Those were like... Oh my God.
Back in the 80s.
Early
90s,
right?
Yeah.
I would have loved to go on one of those games.
I know.
Right. Hey, fans. Happy Memorial Day. We got a good show next week. We got a little Women's World Cup, right?
Preview of the Women's World Cup. We'll take a look at
the French Open.
We got the Preakness. Belmont Stakes. So, and then, of course, we'll be right in the thick of the playoffs for NHL and NBA. So a lot of good stuff coming next week.
Hey, watch the Monte Carlo Sunday morning at 9 a.m. Drink a couple Ipswich 101s. And have a great weekend, fans.